Somorerui in winters is always full of adventure and excitement. Back in 2015, I encountered my first blizzard while camping there with my friend. The roads closed and we were stuck there for over a week before the ITBP opened it and gave us a ride towards Leh. The road to Somorerui was closed again this winter. Nobody was getting in or out. But I did not give up and camped near the Mahe Bridge waiting for the road to open. It was ITBP who again opened the road and they took me along to Somorerui. The next day, everyone suggested that I go stay at the village and then go back to Leh as soon as the road opens. It was a sensible advice, but I ignored it and camped at the lake for the next 5 days, shooting my time-lapse videos. Somorerui is a very windy place, especially in the winters. So the Changpa shepherds dig holes in the ground and erect their tent around it. This way, they'll be below the ground level while the wind blows over them. I needed to avoid the wind as well. So I cleared the snow in one of these campsites and pitched my tent there. It gave me good protection against the wind and this would be my home for the next 5 days. The weather was excellent at Somorerui this year. It made even the mundane chores like collecting water, washing dishes, cooking and eating bland food seem enjoyable. I reveled in the silence around me and passed my time reading books, listening to music, and even tried doing a few video reviews of my camping gear. But the videos did not turn out so great, especially the audio. I have to redo them some other time. Sunrise and sunset are the coldest times of the day. Perfect time to seek the warmth of my sleeping bag, but these are also the best times for photography, especially for my time-lapse videos. So every morning I would wake up before the sunrise, and if the weather was good, I would force myself to get out of my sleeping bag and rush to the lake before the first light hits the mountains. I would start a time-lapse sequence and pace around the ice, walking back and forth constantly. Movement like this is the only way to stay warm in these conditions. Sure, it was difficult, but the results speak for themselves. Finally, it was time for me to leave. So I went to the Korsok village and hoped to get a ride from there to Leh. I was prepared to wait a few days for the ride, but then I got very lucky and got a ride the very next day. But the ride was not to Leh though. They took me to somewhere very special, and you'll find out more about it in the next episode.